Today's topic that I have chosen has to do with vessel, hull, machinery, in general, energy performance monitoring with the aim to reduce pollution, number one, and of course, the fuel bills, these nasty fuel bills. Fouling is bad news because it increases the most important component of resistance, frictional drag resistance. Typically, we observe annually a speed reduction between 2 and 4%. This is quite significant. It is desirable to have an automatic alarm system in place that will tell us when it's time for hull cleaning. Well, somebody, here we have the good, the bad, and the ugly. 6% reduction of speed is equivalent to 18% increase in fuel bills or 18% in pollution. And this increases every year. Somebody might say the ugly, the uglier, and the ugliest. Of course, we don't need a complicated system to monitor the fouling and the reduction of speed. What we need, the basic system, consists of a speed lock and GPS, which is there anyway, a shaft power meter. Power is the product of RPM times torque, so we need a torque meter essentially, and we might, if we want to become fancier, we might add gauge transducers and wave radar to monitor the wave height because it will affect the power. It is imperative to know the measuring principles of the measuring device. If we consider, for example, the speed log, as it says, measures speed. It's based on the Doppler phenomenon and acoustic wave propagation. It is affected by shallow water, drift velocity, ship motions, and water temperature and pressure. And the orientation of the transducers. If in the results we observe a two-knot oscillation, that means we have disturbance, inaccurate results. It is also imperative to know what affects the measurement. For example, the specific fuel oil consumption is a KPI. The devils of smoke are worn injectors and pumps, liners, broken piston rings, high back pressure, foul turbocharger, and air coolers, and leaking exhaust valves. That way, correlation will be possible. On a relative scale, measuring speed over time for fixed draft provides a valid KPI, an alarm clock, to perform hull cleaning. A word of caution here. Sometimes it is necessary to produce a power speed curve for a vessel, whereas sea trials have been performed in ballast draft. It happens always in bulk carriers. Usually, we utilize the admiralty coefficient. Equality of admiralty coefficients is valid only for draft difference below 2.5 meters. For if we have higher difference than that, then we have to utilize model tests or CFD. We need to differentiate between speed through water and speed over ground. The one that does not change is the speed through water. It's the speed that the engine develops. These graphs are very indicative of what will happen when we have a current. current will affect the speed of the ground, will affect where the ship will go. Now, GPS based on satellite location, positioning, measures the speed of the ground. Speed log measures the speed through water. Their difference gives you the current, either positive or negative. Vectorial sum of ship speed and current gives you the speed over ground. Now, the best KPI is the simple KPI. Like, for example, speed loss, we saw the graph. Diesel generator operation, we don't want diesel generators operating at low loads, lower than 50%. Total fuel oil consumption, the ship owner who pays the bill can tell you which ship is more efficient. Specific fuel oil consumption, remember the key relation thing. Light running margin, we don't want to run a heavy propeller. The slip. Slip is the difference between what between the reduction in distance compared to what the ship will do in dragless water. So increased slip is no good. Calibration frequency and leakages. A damaged propeller may increase consumption by as high as 3%. Machine learning is nothing else but experience like, instead of CFD, measure the optimum trim and where it makes a difference, where we have savings. Same for the exotic energy saving devices, the VFDs, and the condition-based maintenance. At one time, I have been asked to deduce when a liner must be replaced due to wear on the basis of millions of data points. Machine learning is a more scientific implementation of trend analysis. What does the future bring? It brings data. Shipping becomes data-centric and data become a valuable commodity. We are running in the era of big data. Big data for weather modeling can provide valuable valuable tool in order to deduce when and where to travel depending on the time of the year. All these have been systematically produced in ISO 19030, which is similar to the common structural rules when we study the scandlings of the vessel. ISO 19030 is nothing else but a tool to harmonize on how people are doing the vessel monitoring. It is not obligatory, but it gives you guidelines how to put the sensors, what sensors, measurement procedures, various filters and corrections, as well as suggests some KPIs. Of course, the enemy of good is the better. But why do we need to do all this work? The answer is in order to enable us to reply to a series of critical questions. What are the operating conditions of the vessel? Does the crew perform as required and report properly? Kind of a big brother-like of thing. Can we apply predictive or necessary maintenance? Are sensors working properly? Very importantly, it enables fast and accurate decisions. Locating inefficiencies, failures can be predicted before they occur. And to satisfy my friend Apostolos and comply with my promise, last night I wished I was honored to get the personality award by SQE, and I made a wish for the young marine professionals to reach mountaintops not yet explored, and unknown pathways and limitless oceans of knowledge. Here comes the Greek translation.